Amidst the opioid epidemic, healthcare providers in Oregon are searching for alternatives to pain pills.
Remember playing with this?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay.
This is Moira Reeves. She's 6 and has second-degree burns throughout her body.
Okay, we're gonna put on the headphones too, just so we got everything taken care of. Can you see okay?
Yeah.
Changing this dressing is excruciating for Moira.
Good job.
But staff at Legacy Oregon Burn Center have an effective non-opioid tool they can use for her pain. It's a technology that's supposed to safely alter Moira's perception of her pain signals.
We can think of those as being different instruments in an orchestra.
Stop.
No, hang on.
If a person is experiencing a greater sense of threat in relationship to something potentially harmful, then the volume of that orchestra is going to go up. If we can begin to help those different brain centers begin to fire for other reasons around pleasurable activities, then we can essentially hijack those brain functions.
That's right, hijack the brain. Using virtual reality devices to immerse patients in computer-generated worlds. Worlds, theoretically, where the pain stops.
That's super fun.
Yeah.
All right.
Other health providers in the Portland area are getting into the VR game. Doctors at Providence Health and Services want to see how VR can be used to help patients after surgery. Linda Boyles was one of those patients.
It was like being cut in two, close to childbirth. That's how intense the pain was.
Past studies show that being immersed inside a computer-generated environment, like this one, made by first-hand technology, drains the brain's neural resources, leaving less attention available to process pain signals. Providence ran a test with 29 cancer patients, all recovering from painful abdominal surgeries.
We were interested in trying it out in inpatient because people don't have a lot to engage their attention besides their pain experience when they're sitting in a hospital bed.
Inside these VR worlds, patients experience calming, often nature-based environments. This one has a river, a forest, and a lot of otters.
So I wasn't sure about how it was going to be. As I am playing this game, I'm really getting into this game, and I forgot about my pain. And it was like 30 minutes of being pain-free.
It's taken over 50 years for VR to become usable in medical settings. This guy has some insight into that.
In the 60s, virtual reality was close to an entire warehouse. You know, it was a massive room of computing power required to create an experience. In the 90s, it was more like a small server room. Today, it can be run off a laptop.
VR devices used to cost upwards of $60,000. Now, you can buy VR headsets for less than $10.
If you can give someone the option to spend an hour in virtual reality as opposed to popping some pain pills to help alleviate their stress, that's an incredibly supportive thing to someone's lifestyle.
Early results from Providence's VR trial show up to a 30% drop in pain. Doctors were also able to reduce opioid dosing by 20%. Now, Providence wants to test VR in their rehab clinics.
Yeah, we're not going the easy route with this one.
I didn't know it was even possible.
This could be a treatment for pain. This could be a treatment for opioid reduction. But without the payers saying, this is worth X amount of dollars per hour of the doctor's time or whoever's time, then it's not going to get widely integrated into the medical community.
Help him on there, but first, we always want to start the application first before we put it on the patient.
Okay. First-hand technology was at Providence's rehab clinic in Gresham to show physical therapists how to use their VR setup.
Close your fingers.
Wow. It is not the magic bullet. However, in some cases, it might be particularly helpful to get an extra boost of an incredibly absorbing and immersive experience. We were able to bring a different world right into the hospital room.
How do we let go of pain? In the battle against our own bodies, doctors of the future might just recommend digital lanterns, otters, and a dose of wonder.